Glad you could make it today. Hopefully you guys are having a fantastic day. I'm hoping that I will today. Because we're going to be trying something new. So believe it or not, in the two and change years that I've been working on Morrowind, I have never actually completed the main quest. We're going to change that. And hopefully we're going to change that before the anniversary starts. So, with that in mind, we got the title screen. It's amazing, isn't it? So, you guys are going to have to help me out here. I know that I want to play a Dunmer, right? Because I know that the Naravarine can be anybody. He can be a woman, in fact. Probably there's a mod out there that lets you be a mud crab or something. But no, it doesn't feel right to me for the Naravarine to be anything other than a Dunmer. So we're going to be a Dunmer, and we're going to be... Well, I don't know if we're going to be a dude or not. I guess we'll have to find out. Ooh, let's turn down the music for the video. By the way, how are my audio levels? Am I coming in a little too high? I think I might be. Alright, so let's just go ahead and pause that music here for a minute. You guys ready? I'm ready. Each event is preceded by the prophecy, but without the hero, there is no event. In the waning years of the Third Era of Tamriel, the prisoner born of a certain day to uncertain parents was sent under guard without explanation to Morrowind, ignorant of the role he was to play in that nation's history.
They have taken you from the Imperial City's prison. First by carriage, and now by boat. To the east, to Morrowind. Fear not, for I am watchful. You have been chosen.
Wake up. We're here. Why are you shaking? Are you okay? Wake up. Stand up. There you go. You were dreaming. What's your name?
Ooh, that's a good question. What should our name be? Well, you know, we are from Cyrodiil, so that means that we're probably not going to have a typical name. Let's just go ahead and say Super Dark. Super Dark, yeah. Let's go ahead and see how it's going to look when we go up to the surface. Because this might just be... Yeah, we'll see.
Well, not even last night's storm could wake you. I heard them say we've reached Morrowind.
See, the filters that we have for this are designed for the creation kit. Or actually the construction set. And that is a lot more... bright than the actual game itself. Plus we have like different shaders and stuff on here, so it's gonna take a little bit of tweaking to figure that out. I promise I'll go ahead and figure it out before next stream.
Get yourself up on deck and let's keep this as civil as possible.
What an asshole. Just got like kidnapped.
Head down to the dock and I'll show you to the census office.
All right, so how does it look now that we're on the surface?
Let's go. Move it along.
Oh my god. Okay, fine. Whatever.
You finally arrived, but our records don't show from where.
Hey, what's going on, man? Ooh, okay. So, now we know that we want to be a dark elf and we probably want to have some music again. So, let's pop that back on. Get some of that heroic music going. Oh man, I forgot like how bad the vanilla faces are. These are gonna have like the messed up Khajiits too, and the Argonians with those crazy bow-legged hips. Nah, I wanna do it, dude. Should be a guy. Can see at least, okay. Love you some vanilla face, such personality. Well, I don't know, I like the beard. Like, I kinda wanna play a young guy though, right? I don't wanna play somebody who's old. I mean, that one isn't so bad. Like, if we change the hair though. Oh man, you gotta do the mohawk. Yeah, that's... It's such a staple though. You want a big one or a small one? I think maybe like a small one. That's kind of like a faux hawk though. The epic adventure of facial makeup and hair cutting. Hey, you know what? If this was Skyrim, this would be 3 hours long. I guarantee it. Feel wrong playing it, yeah. Yeah, I hear ya. No, I want him to be like a guy, and I want him to be kind of on the young side. So that one's not so bad. I mean, chances are I'm just gonna go ahead and mod a new one in, so it doesn't really matter, but for the moment. Why Morrowind when you can Daggerfall? Yeah, Daggerfall is just a little too intense for me. Like, I want to enjoy playing it. As I understand Daggerfall, most of that is just, like, an excuse to torture people who dare go into dungeons, because it's all, like, procedurally generated, and not in a good way, either. Okay, so I'm kind of feeling the mohawk, and I'm kind of feeling something with long hair. Not that. That's ridiculous. So what do you think? Up or down? I say up. I think up. I mean, that's not a bad look right there. Yeah, it's been so long since I've messed with these vanilla faces that it's just... Dungeons are the worst part of Daggerfall. Yeah, definitely. I mean, I say this without actually knowing because I haven't played it, but it's just everything that I've heard. I miss the days when I could make a Dark Elf Van Halen. Alright, I think we're gonna go with this. I think this is our dude. Let me just do one quick cycle of the... that one's not so bad. He's got a scar, though. I don't want him to have a scar. He should be, like, fresh off the boat, yeah. Kind of on the young side.
Great. I'm sure you'll fit right in. Follow me up to the office and they'll finish your release.
Can you guys hear them talking? And is that going to be a big deal? Because I can barely hear them. Doing a playthrough. Yeah, that's true. Oh, you know what? Hey, I completely spaced on putting this up on the social networks. I just put it on the Discord, and then that was it. So we need to fix that. I'll tell you what, we'll go ahead and get this guy completely sorted out, and then... Yeah, they seem kind of quiet to me, too. Okay, who should we be? I tell you what, we're gonna fix the audio levels here for a second. Now, hopefully, it's not going to go ahead and blast out, so we'll see. So I need some help on this. What do you guys think that... What do you think would work for a good Dunmer playthrough? Like, the first time around. Because I'm kind of in between here. I either want to go ahead and play a mage, or I want to play somebody who has a sword, like a warrior. What do you think? Am I using any mods or just doing a vanilla run? It's vanilla-ish. So it's got a couple mods on there, but nothing huge. Like, this is going to feel very, very much like vanilla Morrowind. It's a very light mod list. Oh, hey, thanks for the host, man. This game is so unrealistic. They don't keep you in line waiting for customs. Mage is hard, man. Unarmored. Okay, so not mage. We'll go ahead and do warrior then. First timers makes you not miss. Okay, so... Oh, hey. What's up, Zacharon? Be using the lover stone and adds agility. Okay. So you guys are saying warrior, right? Play a no magic warrior with the Atro for magic resistance. Well, I think I'm going to go with Zacharon here. We'll go ahead and do lovers. You mean like the lover sign, right?
Very good. The letter that preceded, you mentioned you were born under a certain sign. And what would that be?
Long blade or short blade? Okay. But I'm silly, and I played Skyrim yesterday. So believe it or not, Zacharon, I don't usually play Morrowind. I mod it way, way, way more than I actually play it. So I'm relying heavily on chat to help me out with the mechanics here. Alright, so we're going to do lover.
Interesting. Now, before I stamp these papers, make sure this information is correct.
We can go ahead and change the class if we need to do something custom, but what do you guys think? Does that look good? Warrior's not a bad starter class, okay. Longblade gets Dunmer bonus. It's most easy to find good weapons of that type. Yeah, that's what I'm thinking. The only thing that I'm a little bit concerned about is this blocking skill. Like, isn't that something to do with shields? Because I don't plan on having a shield. I plan on probably doing like either doing spears or doing a two-handed longblade. Both medium and heavy armors for majors. Yeah, that's what I'm thinking. So what's better, medium or heavy? Probably heavy, right? So yeah, that 25% agility will lower the missing with trivial enemies. Blocking with shields, yes. Okay, so we don't need to have blocking, or we can at least put that into a minor skill. Is it not letting me actually rename it? Okay, fine, whatever. So this we'll put in as spear. Heavy is better but slower, and bone mold looks cooler and is medium. Well, we might just go ahead and do both of them then. Blocking is extremely important, is it? I thought it was one of those things that was auto-calculated. Medium for the fashion. Okay, so we'll just keep both of them that way. We'll have block as a minor skill. Is that gonna gimp us or anything? Because minor skills only get like a 20... Yeah, blocking is auto-calculated. That's what I thought. If you're not using a shield, it's useless. Well, I'll tell you what, we'll go ahead and we'll keep it as a minor skill. I don't know if we're going to use it or not, but we might as well just have it there. Like, the main thing is I want to be able to use spears, too. That's the big thing. What about this armor thing? Does this need to be a major skill? Oh, hey, thanks for the follow, man. I'm noticing that there isn't any kind of archery here either. Like, do I need to take a marksman or a... Because I'm thinking about swapping out the armor with a marksman. And then maybe just... But for a good point of time, chances are you won't have the money for a two-hander. You might want to take mysticism so you can teleport and you don't need to walk so down. I'm probably just going to go ahead and install that ring of mark and recall. I mean, I know it's a cheat, but that's the only skill that you need for mysticism, right? I should take a minor in mysticism. Okay. Well, I don't really care about axes, so let's take a minor in mysticism. There's other good stuff in mysticism. Well, there's levitate. Okay, so we'll do that then. So I'm guessing, like, the favorite attributes, strength, intelligence, that's fine. Specialization, combat, that's fine too. Like, obviously. Levitation is good. Okay. You can easily get a two-hander long blade at the start, too. Don't know what that guy's talking about. I don't know. I mean, this looks good to me. The only problem that I have with this is that there isn't any kind of protection for, like, long-range stuff. Right? Like, am I just going to be completely useless with a bow and arrow? Or thrown weapons and stuff? Like, is that just something that's not going to work well for this class? Armor is a good miner, if you ask me. Okay. Yeah, that's what I'm thinking. Like, am I going to need enchanting, though? Yeah, I want to have at least a little bit of archery here. Okay, this skill covers the creation, use, and recharging of enchanted items. Skilled enchanters are more useful at creating new items. Well, that's probably not something I'm going to worry about. Enchanted items burn less power. That is probably something I'm going to worry about. And are recharged more efficiently from soul gems for a trained user. Destruction. Is destruction on here? Yeah, I didn't think it was. Enchanting is hard to level up, if you ask me. You don't need block if you're using spears and bows. You can't use a shield at the same time as those weapons. That's a good point. You can't use a shield with that either. Hey, thanks for the follow, man. This is my very first Morrowind playthrough through the main quest, and so this is kind of important. This is like the most important day. So it's good that it showed up. Okay, so we'll get rid of enchanting, and I'm going to put armor under minor skill. And then we'll put marksman here. Heavy weapons like maces, hammers, clubs, and staves. You might want to put long blade in major. You get bonuses from Dunmer Lover and specialization. You can actually hit stuff right away. Okay, so we'll do that. But the question that I have for you, Greatness, is then what should we take out of major skills? Like, long blade seems fine with me inside of a major skill, but like, what should we swap out? Medium armor? Potentially? You should think about putting in Longblade as a major. Yeah, that's exactly what Greatness said. We'll take out blunt weapons. You don't need blunt. Okay. So what should we put in minor skill then? I mean, would restoration be a good one? That's a... I feel like we're going to be so... not very powerful when it comes to magic that I don't want to, like, add in more magic stuff. You want a way to handle locks, so either security or alteration. Alright, I'll leave it up to you guys. What do you think? You want some way to deal with dialogue, either illusion, charm, or speechcraft? Ooh, that's a good point. We need to go ahead and talk to people. Talking to people is probably going to be a huge thing that we have to do. I'll tell you what, we'll do speechcraft. And then maybe we can find a trainer to help us with the whole lockpicking thing. Or you can use your lock bash mod. That's a good point, but we're doing like a vanilla thing here. See, this is the thing about old games. Like, in Skyrim, you don't really have this kind of issue. Like, if you want to get better at lockpicking, you just pick a lot of locks or something. But here you have to decide what your character is going to be right from the beginning. And so it's just like so much pressure. I think we're going to roll with this. Unless anybody has major objections, I think this is what we're going to do. Like, my only temptation here is to take out block and then to put in restoration. Like, to... Well, aside from burst sign and race, you can actually take miscellaneous skills and raise them into usefulness. It's a good point. I guess what I'm talking about here is just like a head start in specific areas. So you think I should take restoration instead of logging? I mean, I think that's probably going to do us more good in the long run, right? Yeah, but I want to have that flexibility greatness. Besides, I think that swords are probably going to be easier to find than... The difference is you'll not level up from raising skills that are not major and minors. Ah, see, I didn't know that. Okay. Okay, I think that's it. I think we got it.
Show your papers to the captain when you exit to get your release fee.
I should probably put these somewhere where they're actually visible, so that you guys can see them.
Continue through to the next building and talk to Sellus Gravius.
Yeah. I know, you're supposed to, like, steal the limeware platter. Don't think I've forgotten our wager. I want this dagger as sharp as a scamp's claw by morning. Alright, so yeah, I'm gonna steal everything. Because why not? Nobody plays with inventory open 24/7. Hey, what do you know? I actually unlocked it. That's awesome. Not as a... not as dumb as I look. Ooh, that's good. This is new. Like, I know the book isn't new, but I'm saying that it being full screen like this, this has got to be one of the new MGE things. Alright, Morrowind code patch things. I like it. It's good. You basically can't see anything inside. Okay. That's, it's good to know. Give me a second. I'll see if I can go ahead and fix the filters on this. Oh, yeah. It's, like, basically dark. How's it looking now? Can you see stuff? Much better. Okay.
There's someone watching me. I can tell.
Yeah, it's because I have filters on the OBS, and then I also have shaders inside of Morrowind, which the shaders don't exist inside of. Doesn't matter. It's fine. Hey, what is this? It's a ring of healing. That's awesome. Wonder what that's all about.
Your papers, please.
I know, but I like it larger, man.
Grab him.
What? Okay, I might have done that wrong. Did I just, like, lose all of that stuff that I stole? Fine, whatever. First, let me take your identification papers. Oh, I'm sneaking. Oh, that's what it is. But my big health bars are covering it up. God damn it. All right. First, let me take your identification papers. Thank you. Word of your arrival has only reached me yesterday. I am Celis Gravius, but my background is not important. I'm here to welcome you to Morrowind. I guess we'll have to fix that then. Alright. Yes, you're in Morrowind. I don't know why you're here, or why you were released from prison and shipped here, but your authorization comes directly from Uriel Septim the Seventh himself. I don't need to know any more than that. When you leave this office, you are a free man, but before you go, I have instructions on your duties. Instructions from the Emperor. So pay careful attention. Okay. This package came with the news of your arrival. You're to take it to Cassius... Cosades? In the town of Balmora. Go to Southwall Corner Club. Ask for him. They'll know where to find him. Serve him as you would serve the Emperor himself. I also have a letter for you. And your dispersal to your name. Okay. Fair enough. Yeah, okay. Knight Errant of the Imperial Legion. Report to Caius in Balmora. I can't tell you where to find him, but you're to go to the south. Okay, fair enough.
If I can help, I will, but don't take too much time.
I mean, I kind of want to just kill him right now, but whatever. We can wait. Are you the one that the boat dropped off? Odd to see a boat arrive at that time of day. I hope the Imperials treated you okay. I swear they took my ring. I swear one of the guards has it. I had it last week before their weekly Let's Shake Down the Fargoth ritual. An engraving healing ring. Family heirloom of mine. You haven't seen it, have you? What do you guys think? Should I give it to him or not? Could be useful. I'm leaning towards giving it to him. I mean, you're new, you're fresh off the boat, you don't know anybody. I mean, you could go ahead and just keep it for yourself, but yeah, I'm just going to give it to him. You found it! Amazing! Thank you! You're now my favorite friend. Ooh, wow, that gave us like a ton of disposition with this guy. I'll be sure to tell the others, especially my friend Ariel, who runs the trade house here. Go see him, he'll be happy to see you now. Alright, fair enough. Oh man, those animations. Welcome to Ariel's Trade House. I barter for goods or coin. I also have a small selection of spells for sale. No credit. You want a little advice? That's free. All that's free. Would you like to hear about our most popular potions or our most popular scrolls? Scrolls? Wow, kind of went dark there. Okay, so let's see what this guy has. I think we might want to get some armor, right? First and foremost. Wow, that's light armor. Do we have any medium armor? Value 90. Hey, Rogowski, how's it going, dude? Yeah, and then let's sell some of this stuff off. Do not need a spoon, thank you. Ooh, that's not bad. Let's do the Imperial Chain one instead of the iron. You'll never know when you need a spoon. That's very true. Okay, so now I don't feel completely unprotected. Probably want to have something more than just a little dagger, though. Think we might go ahead and just buy like a two-handed sword or something. Like, we really don't have a lot of gold. That's the problem. All right, it's a little expensive, but I'm gonna go for it. I hear that Hriskar upstairs is having some financial troubles. Can't seem to win a wager these days. Let's pay him a visit.
I do enjoy a good conversation.
You look like you could use a friend, Outlander. Perhaps I can be your friend. I'd like you to help me recover some gold. Okay. That's right, see? I've had a run of bad luck playing nine holes and lost a bit of money. Normally I'd be fine. We can usually keep some gold in our pockets just from the money the locals pay us for protection. Oh, okay, so I see how this is. But I know some of them are holding out on me, especially that little Fletcher Fargoth. He's come up light the past few weeks when I've shaken him down. I know he's stashing it somewhere. I'd like you to find Fargoth's hiding place. I know that little Fetcher's got it one somewhere in town, just not sure where yet. I've already gone through his whole house, so I know he's not hiding it there. I'd like you to find out where he's stashing his gold. If you can, I'll give you the share of the wealth. Are you up for it? Well, I don't know. We just made him a friend. But if we can steal from him and we don't get caught, I mean, hell, we can say that we're gonna do it and not do it, right? Excellent. Here's what I want you to do. I'm not sure where he goes, but I know he wanders around town at night. Watch his movements for the best vantage point on top of the lighthouse south town. That will give you a nice view of all Seyda Neen. If you keep an eye on where he goes, I'm sure you'll be able to figure out where he's hiding that gold. Okay. Fair enough. Okay, if it's 20 gold or something, he can keep it, but like if it's, I don't know, hundreds? So, we're doing the main quest. Actually, technically, we're doing a side quest at the moment.
My time is precious, so make it quick.
Because I have never actually done that before. I should watch him at night. Okay, so we'll kind of just hang out here for a little bit. Making a massive city overhaul, but never played the main quest. I know, right? Well, you would be surprised the amount of time that I've actually... Ooh, what happened? Your unarmored skill is increased to 6. Cool. No, I know there's like some irony in that. Oh, you can't see him. Okay, awesome. See, if we had distant land on right now... Well, technically we do, but if we had more distant land on right now, we could see Vivek just off in the distance. Alright, so it's 12 o'clock here. Let's wait till... 6 o'clock will be evening, right? And so we'll just kind of chill out here for a little bit. No, like, I've never actually played all the way through. I mean, I have a pretty good idea what happens. Like, you can't go ahead and work on a game for 3 years and not know, well, two years and not know how things are going to go. So, like, I'm not too concerned about spoilers at this point. Morrowind's always been more of a sandbox to me than an actual game, though, so... Oh, that's so funny. You can looking at it from this distance and with the NPCs in motion and stuff, you can totally see where the path grids are. So how long am I going to have to wait for this guy anyway? I can press T to progress time. Yeah, that's true, I can. But right now, I'm at 6 o'clock in the afternoon. 6 o'clock in the evening. Which is when the... Actually, it's like 7 right now. Which is when the sun sets. And I'm guessing that when that sun sets, that's when Fargoth is going to get triggered to walk someplace. Wait until midnight. Okay. Ah, that's clever. He's the only one with a torch. Okay, so now the guard has one too. Like, it would have been better if he was the only one with a torch. And him skulking about. Man, I just cannot get over those old animations. I'll probably have to fix that at some... Oh, well, I'll probably have to fix that at some point. I guess this is kind of like old hat for all of you, isn't it? Sneaking with a torch. Okay, so it's in the pond. Fair enough. Wait till he gets out of sight. Probably want to wait until like the guard isn't there either. Oh, okay. This isn't Skyrim. What was I expecting? That was kind of stupid. Yes, jumping from a building actually hurts. Thus ends the quest of the Nerevarine. Wow, that's kind of ignominious. I'm just so used to like... All right. Not my best showing. Hey, how's it going? Oh, okay. It's a... I don't know, guys. 300 gold. That's not... I'll tell you what we're gonna do. Since we're playing like a morally ambiguous character here, we will go ahead and take the gold. I'm going to take all of it. And then at a later date, we'll return it with more stuff. Feels kind of dirty. Okay, so I need to heal myself. That's actually...
I suppose it is my duty to help those less fortunate than myself.
Morally ambiguous? Yeah. Oh, is there not like a wait until healed thing? Or do I need to be inside to do that? Take the gold, buy a sword with it, use it to murder him. Okay, well, I need to have... something to heal myself. Because apparently I am not that bright. Okay. You heal while waiting when out of town. Okay, so like it's weird when it's... waiting is different than sleeping. You can't sleep in the middle of town. No, but there is a... There's a bed, though. I know there's a bed, because I saw it. I think I took Restoration as a minor spell. Where is my... Okay, it's over here. Hey, what's going on, man? Yeah, I am struggling through trying to... Yeah, there I am again. Ah, see, until healed. Gotcha. I'm struggling trying to figure out how to play this game. It's been fun. We did a little base shooting or bungee jumping without the cord or the parachute. Laughs were had by all. It's an engraved ring of healing, by the way. That's a good point. Okay, so I know a little bit about Seyda Neen. I do, because I've spent a little bit of time in Seyda Neen. Beyond about like where this dude falls out of the sky, that's about the limit of where I know the quest is gonna go. Like the quests in this game. Specifically. So anything beyond this point, it's just like, I don't know. Go buy yourself a sword. I already did. I got a sword. I've got a long sword. And we are not going to use those. not until we can afford to. Need like a slow fall potion. Okay, so I think Balmora is this way, right? Am I going the wrong way? I thought Balmora was this way. Or pray that there's water where you land. Yeah, that's a good point. I could just go ahead and fly to the slaughter fishes. They have no mercy. That's kind of cool. Oh, shit. What's a... My very first kill. So yeah, I'm just kind of wandering right now, trying to find where Balmoro is. I thought it was like up north and then a little bit to the east. If I remember correctly. So yeah, this guy is kind of fresh off the boat, as one is. He's really good at hitting things, apparently. And that's about it. Okay, yeah, this is much more Arcadian Isles here. Follow the river and you'll reach Balmora. Yeah, of course. Of course. Because there's bridges in Balmora. Why didn't I think of that? Thank you, Fire. I would be completely lost without you. I never did the Fargoth quest, though. Right? That was a new one for me. Are these guys going to be friendly? Could have used a Silt Strider traveling services. Wow, no, you can't do that, man. Kills the mood of the exploration. Don't ever take the Silt Strider the very first time. Hotkey is F to take all, really? Nope. That's got to be a mod that you installed or something, because F to take all does not work. I think we've had this conversation. Music would be nice too. Like, is the music not playing? It just might be a little too quiet for you guys. Because I know that we had to change our sound levels. I have not rebound my keys, at least I don't think so. This is a fresh install, so probably not. Nope, not working. This is a complete... is the music too loud? It sounds kind of loud to me. You're gonna have to tell me on this. I'm a miner in the Shuck Egg Mine, but I'm just here taking a break. Okay. You must have not enabled the MCP feature then. Ah, so you gotta tell me these things. Where's it at? Is it like under interface or something? Yeah, this music's too loud. At first it seemed the fuss about the Nerevarine prophecy was just silly superstition. Then I learned that the Dunmer have been waiting for Lord Nerevar to come back for centuries. The Incarnate, they call it. Every few years an Ashlander appears, and the tribes call him the Incarnate. Then the temple goes out, hunts him down, and reveals him as a fake. Why does the temple worry so much about it?
I'm a busy guy, so if you could hurry this up.
Quarmer foragers and warriors won't attack us, since they're used to our smell. But they attack intruders, and you smell like an intruder. But don't worry, the queen squirts out foragers and warriors like seeds. If the foragers and... that's kind of gross, actually. If the foragers and warriors bother you, kill them, or run past, whatever's easier. But do us a favor and don't kill the workers. They won't bother you, and we need them to keep the queen laying the eggs ripening. Keep the queen laying eggs. They won't bother you, and we need them to keep the queen laying,
and the eggs ripening. Okay. Whatever. You guys do not seem like you are going to give out a good quest, so... Now, the reason why, the impetus as to why I'm doing the quests and stuff here and actually doing a playthrough of the main quest is because I'm about to start work on the dialogue. And so I want to get a good appreciation for the voice that Morrowind has. And the only way that you can do that is to sit down and play the game. So that's what we're doing. Hey, look at that! That almost looks like a city. By the way, I never got an answer on the music. Is it too quiet? Is it too loud? Is it just right? Okay, so I'm gonna wait till daybreak. Because I feel like that's what my character would do. Is there like an inn or something I can go at? Home sweet home. Yeah, I gotta say, like, out of all the cities, Balmora feels most like home to me. Maybe it's because it feels like most normal. And I never really spend a lot of time in here either. Music sounds okay. Alright, awesome. Where is the inn? Can I tell you about a cool sword that you can get about more? It's kind of a saber. Yeah, absolutely. Absolutely. What sword are you talking about? No metagame, laming. Well, I don't know. Is it going to break the game? Is it like a Daedric sword or something? I tell you what, let's keep that in your back pocket, and then if I need to go ahead and have a sword, basically you have to cheat to get it. Okay, no, like we're gonna go ahead and do this playthrough like I have never actually played this game, because there's a good amount of content that I actually haven't seen on this. Yeah, it's an Ebony sword, yeah, okay. I mean, you can tell me, but I'm not going to play it like the character knows about the sword. If he was to discover it on its own, then that's another thing altogether. Alright, so we need to have an inn. Well, let's see. He was talking about a South Wall corner club. So let's go to the South Wall and see if he's there. Are you taking off? All right. Thanks for hanging out, dude. Might be worth visiting the temple to grab some healing spell while you're in town so you can start leveling that restoration minor skill. That is not a bad idea. Okay, Malice, take it easy, man. I'm probably going to be streaming here for hours and hours and hours. So if you can't get to sleep, I'll probably still be here. Like, this is weird. I know these places, and yet I don't at the same time. I suppose makes a certain amount of sense for the Neravarine. Like, I know these places in broad strokes, but I don't know them, like, from a ground level like this. Okay, so you've got just... No, I want to, like, actually have a spell. Do you remember the guy that I'm supposed to talk to get, like, that sells spells? Or do I need to be a member of the Imperial, or not the Imperial, the Temple to get him to sell me stuff? You're a new face, so what can I tell you about Balmora? I like to swap the latest rumors when there's something juicy enough to gossip about, or maybe you have a little secret. Maybe I have one to trade. The Legion Champion, Larius Varro, over at Moonmoth Legion Fort, has sworn an oath to stop corruption. He hasn't had much luck going through official channels. The syndicates have got their people covered, coming and going. He'll never get anywhere working the system. He's gonna have to find someone who can get him around the system, or through the system, like straight and hard through the system. Oh, okay. Yeah, I was just looking for her, and that's all. Okay, so we've got 300 gold here. Life Leech, Shock Guard, Potion. Absorbs Fatigue. I don't know, that's a lot of gold to sink in on something that's... I think we probably want to get the Mark spell and the Restoration spell, right? That should be our priority, and then we can go ahead and... There are several spell vendors. Might want to check... Well, I mean, we're going to have to get Mark and Recall at some point. I just don't know if it needs to be this... exact moment or not. Ah, okay. Mark and Recall, there we go. And Mark is godsend. Okay, so we need to get some more money, don't we? Omsivi intervention for 1 second on Solf. That seems like a really good spell, right? Let's go ahead and do that. And then I probably want to get some restore healths. Yeah, teleport you to the nearest temple. I mean, I'd love to get Mark and Recall, but we just don't have enough money for that. But it's good that we know that both of those people have the spells that we need to make that work. So we will just go ahead and have to come back here at some point. Alright, not bad. So, there was something about a council club. We need to go to the south wall. And... probably just chill out for a little bit. That is not from a mod. That is just from... the vanilla game. Like, the only mods that I have installed at the moment are... MGEXE, which isn't really a mod. It's a graphics overhaul. Something to help with the speed of... getting from place to place. Ah, here we go. I think there's one for Thunder, and that might actually be it.
What say you?
I really don't have time for this, so make it quick.
Greetings, citizens. I am Sotilde. This town is Balmora,
council seat of House Slalu, were loyal citizens of the Empire and proud of it. Well, most of us anyway. So are you looking for someone in particular, or are you looking for a service? Actually, someone in particular is probably who we need to, we need to click. None of the Hlalu counselors live in Balmora. Naleno Dorvenin at the council hall is the ranking Hlalu local. At the Fighters Guild, Eldris Fireeye is the steward. Okay, they're just talking about, like, who's there. I just found that out. That old sugar tooth? That old sugar tooth? I'm not sure where he's living now, but... ask Bacola, the owner. He'll know. Okay. So, Bacola. Excuse me. Good day, I'm Bacola, publican of the South Wall here at Balmora. We rent beds, and I have a limited selection of goods for barter. If you're new here, I can tell you where to... Okay. No. Tell me about Caius. Doesn't even try to pronounce the last name. Nope! We haven't even gotten to the Daedric Temples yet. Daedric Shrines. Not even gonna try. Rent a little bed and breakfast just up the hill on the north edge of town. Okay, so north edge. Go out the front door, not the upper door to the terrace. Okay, out the front door, then right up the stairs, then left at the top of the stairs, and down at the end of the street. That would stress me the hell out if I was a kid playing this. Okay, so not that one. And then it's up the hill. Okay, so we know it's around here somewhere. Them directions kind of hard. A lot of kids never found the main quest. Hey, there we go. There we go. We found him. What's up, Caius? What? Yes, I'm Caius. But what do you mean you were told to report to me? What are you talking about? All right. So you say your name is Blink, and you've been told to report to me and deliver a package. Perhaps you'll let me look at it? I can tell him no. Like, I could go all this way and be like, hey, I've got something for you. Well, can I see it? No. That would never happen in Skyrim. Oh my god, that's so funny. Yes, very interesting. So, it says here the Emperor wants me to make you a novice in the Blades, and that means you'll be following my orders. Are you ready to follow my orders, Blink? No.
Come on, I haven't got all...
Alright, so let me get this straight. I was a prisoner... who got then turned into a courier. So I deliver a package, and then he tells me, okay, and by the way, you have to go ahead and do everything that I tell you. How does that even make sense? I'll come back to it at some point. That's ridiculous right there. Kinryu, thank you so much for the follow, man.
I have to come up with some sort of... He gave you the option to say no, at least. That's true. That is true. And then he got, like, really upset. No, I don't want to do that. I want to go ahead and hang around town for a little bit and see if there's any quests. So there was a council club around here. And see if there's anybody who needs a job done. Oh yeah, Larius Varro over at Moonmoth Legion Fort. Okay.
Sorry, stranger, Mike.
So Moonmoth. Moonmoth. I'm trying to remember here. Moonmoth is relatively close to Balmora, correct? Well, they did endeavor to get you out of prison. I mean, they're the ones who put me in prison in the first place, so... Yeah, not really feeling it. I don't want to do the Moonmoth quest yet. Okay. Well, then let's talk to somebody on the outside then. Maybe they'll have a quest. It's high level. Got some people walking around. Better off joining a guild. Don't mind answering some questions, okay. In case you didn't know, weapons and armors are less effective when they get worn out. Good to know. Repair them yourself if you have the skill, or take them to a smith for repair.
I'm waiting.
Lalu and Telvanni have been fighting over... Wow. Odurninran. For years. Okay, well, what's that? Wow, okay. That's, that did not work. Hey, what's up, Neb? Everyone's talking about the murder of Raylan Hlano. Hlalo. Who? Wait a minute here. He's saying everyone's talking about the murder of this dude. Okay, fine. I ask him who it is, and he's like, who? Really? All right. I don't even think I have 100 gold. Well, I do. I have 145. All right. If she doesn't like me enough. Yeah, but see, the thing is, like, I don't know. Like, my speechcraft is just not...
You seek to challenge me?
It's a subtle way of saying I expect money from this information. Well, I don't have any money. That's the problem. I'm trying to find a quest that I can do. Dunmer will like you more. Yeah, that's true. Because I'm the same race. 45. Okay, so I think we're not going to get anywhere with this. What we might end up having to do is to just go ahead and go into a dungeon and take our chances. Am I really just playing Morrowind? Yeah, that's all that this is going to be. Like, I'm trying to get that Morrowind vibe so it doesn't feel... different when I start writing for Outlander. But that's all that this stream is going to be. But yeah, most of the quests in Balmora especially are guild quests. There's a few others, but they're a little hard to find. Okay, so we will go ahead and forge on forward and try and find some sort of ancestral tomb or cave or something. Ah, okay, so this is where the fort is. This is Moonmoth. The quests back instead of Neen are good money. Oh, okay. Let's head back there then. And this time I do not mind taking the Strider. You know, that actually makes sense. If it's instead of Neen, they're probably, like, that's the starting level. Probably would be a little bit easier. Yeah, the beginning does feel a little bit awkward when you tell Caius no. Well, I mean, like, he didn't even say, by the way, you're gonna get some good loot doing this. Or have some money. He's just like, no, you're gonna go ahead and serve me. And I'm just like, ah. I mean, I don't mind doing that question. I just have to have a reason to do it. Yeah, but the problem is he doesn't say that, though. I mean, I know that he does that. But how the hell is this character supposed to know that? So, I don't know. We'll give it some time to think about. Did I pick the steed as Josiah? No, I just went in and cheated. I did not. Use a console command. So the speed that I have is just based off of like the signs and stuff. But the reason why I'm running so fast is. It's just because I installed a mod. Because that's one of the very few things that I do not mind. Fixing. Latest rumors. There's a local tax collector. Ventilus is missing. No surprise, he wasn't really liked us here.
I suppose it is my duty to help those.
Surely the character wants to know what the hell's going on. Not to mention he's having weird dreams with gods talking to him. Yeah, but like it's a dream. That's easy enough to dismiss, right?
What's this about?
Take the Silstrider to Vivig or Balmora, fast and cheap, no trouble with wild animals and smugglers and bandits and outlaws. Go see Darva May over at the Strider port and over the bridge along the water and tell her Vodinus sent you. I skipped a longer comment. Is it this one? Daedra, you know what they are, right? Well, Daedra shrines are where Daedra cults worship Daedra. Bad people who summon bad Daedra. Stay away from them. Why? Because Daedra are nasty, and the folks that worship them are even nastier.
Go ahead, stranger.
No, I don't want to talk to guards.
Let's hear it.
Oh, comments in the chat. Okay, let's, I suppose the reason is curiosity. The Emperor himself arranged to free you from prison and send you to a strange place with a package for an old guy with crazy abs. That is a fair point. I think the chief motivation of starting the main quest is joining the Blades was the secret stipulation for your release. All right, well, I'll tell you what. Let's do a dungeon here, real quick. And then after a while, after he's thought about it for a minute, and be like, oh, okay, I'll come back. I'll just go ahead. I'll check it out. I'll see what's going on. Not going to commit myself. I mean, I will, but not really. This guy's word is kind of a little bit flexible. Okay, so I know that there's a dungeon around here somewhere, right? Like, I'm pretty sure that there's a dungeon around here. It would be funny if people jumped on Discord with you to read those lines with various voices, but Twitch delay is probably too big for that. Dungeon's on the other side. It looks away from the Siltstrider. Well, yeah, that's where I thought it... Yeah. Okay. I think we're good here. Let me go ahead and pick some of these things first. I don't really think I'm going to be using a lot of these alchemical ingredients, but I might be able to sell them off for something, so... And I'm kind of poor at the moment. Probably like a minute to, or two... Probably like 2 or 5 minutes behind. Maybe you can try restarting the stream? That would, sometimes that happens with me. Like, I'm about a minute behind. Oh! Oh, I'm okay. Hi.
Stupid.
Okay. Yes. Okay. Now we need to gear up. This is like all light armor. Huh, I thought she dropped more than that. All right, fair enough. If you're using the code patch, the draw weapon button takes all and closes the container, really speeds up picking. Yeah, that's what I thought too, but apparently, like, the code patch isn't working correctly. Maybe that's on me. It probably is. It's something that I will go ahead and add next time. Uh-oh. Oh man, like, I have, like, no health. Well, that didn't do much. Let's save real quick. Oh! Take the Gandalf robe? What? Where? Like this one? Oh, yeah, you're right. Okay. I'm not looting as I should. By the way, the combat works in such a way that spam clicking is not good. Cloth left bracer, huh? Alright, we'll take all these. I have a lockpick. Let's give that a shot. Oh, wait, I can just go ahead and... I can just take it. Like, it's not even locked. What am I doing? Ooh, I'm kind of weighed down, aren't I? Alright, I'm gonna say that this guy is kind of a recovering... Ooh... I was gonna say, like, a recovering addict. So he'll leave the moon sugar, but he'll take the skooma. It might be fun so that, like, every time that we find skooma, we have to take it. Like, we have to use it then and there. Yeah, let's have that be a thing. Ooh, Iron Saber, that's not bad. Oh, okay, is that the only way forward in this dungeon? I think that's the... Looks like we're gonna go underwater. I might wanna take off my torch then. There we go. Oh, that's cool, that's a skeleton. I wonder what happened there. Sweet skooma. So obviously he had some sort of bad end. A bit unlucky for him. I think this is just kind of a dead end here, isn't it? No pun intended. Actually, that's probably exactly what they intended. I'm over encumbered. Okay. That's not good. Let's get rid of this shield. Went fishing in a cave-in? Yeah, why didn't he just swim out then, though? Rock must have hit him. I feel like there's a part of this dungeon that I'm just not seeing right now. Oh, here we go. This is it. No, I don't want the probe. I want the lockpick. You think? Might want to unload some of this? Yeah, that's not a bad idea. Let's do that. And then I can come back. It's like right next to her. Oh! Hello. Yeah, why not? Free some cats. Free some lizards.
Yes, honored guest.
Make some friends. This hat is ridiculous, by the way. How do I get out of this dungeon? That's a... Oh, there it is. There it is. Just follow the dead bodies. Don't I have another skooma? Yeah, there it is. I mean, I'm smiling at it because it's just so stupid looking, but yeah. Not really my style. Come on, there's got to be like a decent helm somewhere. Moon sugar? Like, I don't have any moon sugar. Oh, I might have some moon sugar. There you go. Now I don't. No helmet is best helmet. Few pieces of heavy armor there. Yeah, that's what I'm thinking too. Wow, I've got like... There we go. I was gonna say I have a lot of stuff, but no, this isn't me. Alright, so I don't think I need two of these things. That's fine. And we don't really need chitin throwing stars, do we? Like, I feel like they're not going to really do a lot of damage. If they were ebony darts or something, then sure, but... Yeah, not so much. And I don't need the daggers either. Yeah, and then let's get rid of the ingredients too, because I don't need these at all. Oh, does the ingredients not have any price on them? Seriously? Hmm. Oh, is one of the swords better? Oh, well, I guess it's like a little too late now. Well, look, I've got three swords. It's fine. I'll be good. Ingredients are priceless. They have a price. That's what I thought. I thought that they had a price. What happens when I give it to them? Okay, yeah, so... It just doesn't show up on the tooltip, but they do have a price. I could not see it, see? On the tooltip, it does not have a price. So I don't know what that's all about. Do they have torches? Torches would be nice. Torches, candles. I'm starting to think that MCP didn't install correctly. Which is fine. It just means I need to reinstall it. Okay, so this is light stuff. Ooh, hey, there's an Imperial chain. Is that the only one, though? Like, seriously? And I don't want the robe. That's fine. Get rid of the robe. And I just don't want the hat. I'm sorry, guys. I know it's iconic, but come on. It's really ridiculous looking. All right, there's torches that you can loot from that first dungeon. Awesome. Okay. We'll do that then. I mean, I want some gauntlets, but... yeah, okay, and then we'll get rid of the extravagant robe and the expensive ring. And the cloth left bracer. Actually, no, we'll keep that for now. We'll keep that for now. Okay, I think we're good on this. And we will go back to that dungeon then. Oh, hey, why am I afflicted with something? Drain attribute. Okay, it's the skooma. Is that gonna last throughout the entire game? Am I gonna need to, like, cure myself of that? Did I customize my MCP or just... I just went with the defaults, dude. This is a wondrous encounter. Do I carry around 3 pairs of pants for RP reasons? Do I have 3 pairs? I mean, I guess it's laundry day. Ooh, that looks better. Yeah, let's... I kind of want the shirt, though. That's... there we go. That looks better. And we'll swap out the pants.
What's this about?
I'm waiting.
I think it's a few minutes for the skooma. Yeah, it popped away. Cool. Cool. Wait, you can eat moon sugar, right? It's an ingredient, so you can eat it. I mean, if that's the case, then that needs to be a thing that we do. The code patch defaults are just bug fixes. Yeah, that's what I thought. Are these the torches that you can steal? They are! Awesome. I never would have known that. Okay, what's going on here? We got a little... Looks like we got a little clipping here. Maybe you should have had a cat if you like moon sugar so much. Nothing wrong with Khajiits, man. Khajiits are my friends. This is kind of a fun little dungeon. You can tell that they spent a lot of time trying to nail this first one down. Oh wait, is something attacking me? It is. Yeah, just tweaking some small things before bed. Oh, hey, Neb is here. Neb is here. I need to pull out my candlestick and see what I have gotten myself into here. Oh man, it ran out. Okay. Well, we have torches now, so it's fine. It's fine. If I can find them. Awesome. I think that's it. I think that's the entire dungeon. And we didn't even die. That is incredible. What's up, guys? Yes, welcome to everybody who is new to the stream. Today we're going to do something different. We are doing something different. Normally, I mod the hell out of Morrowind, but right now, I'm sitting back and playing it. For once. He is the Morrowind newbie slayer. I did! I almost died to that robed guy. Because I forgot to heal myself. I almost died because I jumped off of the lighthouse. Alright, let's sell off a couple more things here, and then we'll go back to Caius and be like, hey, yeah, I'm just kind of curious. We'll sell off some stuff. We can sell off the extra pairs of pants. And the shirt. Is there like a right pauldron? Because that would be nice. I feel like we're getting sort of the bottom of the barrel here. You should try doing the text collector's quest that the NPC mentions earlier. The Breton who helped you in character, Jen, gives more details, you think. Okay, let's go over there and find out. Okay, so that's the Imperial. Are you talking about this guy?
What's this about?
Because I think those were the only three guys. Do I have to raise his persuasion up? Because that's not going to go well. Yeah, no. Just wasting time there. Have to find the body first. Okay. Well, I say we head on towards Caius.
Quickly, Outlander, or go away.
This isn't Battlestar Galactica. Caius, I say we go back to Caius. Perhaps you need to find the body first. Perhaps.
Why walk when you can ride?
Yes, it's been too long. Hey, so I jumped off the thing and I took some damage, but at least I leveled up a little. Speaking about that, I wonder when I'm actually going to level up. I'm still a level 1, right? Yeah. Alright, let's see what this guy has to say. Are you ready to join the Blaze and follow your orders, Blink? Sure. Why not? Good, welcome to the service, Novice Blink. Now you belong to the Blades. Yeah, okay, we'll see how long that lasts. We're the Emperor's eyes and ears in the provinces. You can use my bed if you need to rest, but leave my personal stuff alone unless I say otherwise. If you like, you can improve your modest skills with our Blades trainers now. Or, if you're in a hurry, I can give you orders right away. But don't forget to visit the Blades trainers. Blades trainers, okay. These Blades agents offer training. Not free, of course, but cheap for a fellow agent. Okay, so Nine Toes and Balmora and Caldera. Good to know. First thing, Pilgrim. You're new, and you look it. Here's 200 drakes. Go get yourself a decent weapon or armor or a spell. And second thing, you need a cover identity. Around here, freelance adventurer is a common profession. Sign on with the Fighters Guild, Mages Guild, or Imperial Cult, or Imperial Legion. Advance in the ranks, gain skill and experience, or go out on your own and look for freelance work or trouble. That's what we were just doing. Then, when you're ready, come back, and I'll have orders for you. Alright, so basically, he's telling us to go ahead and work for somebody else for a while. Which is fine. So who do you think? I'm leaning towards Redoran, personally. I mean, we're basically a warrior. We're never going to be a great Talvani mage. What do you guys think? Yeah, that's what I'm thinking. Redoran. That would make the most sense to me. Mercenary work with the Fighters Guild. Easy stuff. Okay, so where is this Fighters Guild then? Redoran has the coolest armor. Sure. Kinda.
Come on, then. Say something or move on.
West of the Odai River, looking up towards the temple. Okay, west looking up towards the temple. The Fighters Guild is halfway up on your right. West of the Odai River, looking up towards the temple. Halfway up on your right. There it is. Man, I wish you could just go ahead and stick a... I know that you guys dislike quest markers. Okay, that's fine. Well, that is something that we can disagree on. But I would love to have something where I could just right-click and then have a marker show up. That would be super convenient. I mean, you could mark the map, but, like, that doesn't really... Does that show up on the minimap? Like, at all? Because it doesn't look like it. Alright, so this is 8 plates, not what I want. Hey, Fighter's Guild, there we go. No, but I'm saying like custom markers where if you mark something on the map here, then it would show up on a compass here, and then maybe it would show up on the door or something. Greetings, citizens. I'm Facile. Welcome to Balmora. We're House Hlalu Town. Loyal citizens of the Empire. What can I do for you? Okay, so I want to join. Show some respect. You are in the most stalwart guild of warriors this side of death. Okay, so we need to see Fire Eye. Idris Fireeye, okay.
Tell me what this is about.
Well, speak up, Dark Elf. What do you want? Are you here to join the Fighters Guild? Well, yes, I am. You look like you could take care of yourself. Well, I am level 1. I did clear a single dungeon. Before I sign you up, you might want to look at the Fighters Guild charter. Are you ready to sign up now? Okay, well, let's take a look. Not that it matters. Your duties are to your lords and brethren. In all ways, proceed with honor and valor. Keep a keen and watchful mind, and never succumb to the craven tricks of the weak. As a member, you are permitted to use items in our equipment chests. It is traitorous to fight or thieve from other members of your guild. If you break these rules, you must speak with at least a warder of the guild to redeem your standing. Do you feel like you can uphold these simple tasks? You are now Blink, Associate of the Fighters Guild. Work hard, follow orders, and you'll do just fine. Seek me out if you feel you're ready for advancement. Alright. Your talents are noteworthy. But some question the depth of your devotion. Perform more duties for the Fighters Guild, and you will earn your place. Okay, so what kind of duties? I have a very simple contract to end an infestation of cave rats. You might be able to handle it. Maybe. My mother was a cave rat. Go play Skyrim for that. This is the real Elder Scrolls. Serious business. No quest markers for you, boy. Yeah, I know. This is some hardcore stuff right here. Like, this is so adventurous. Go to Darrain Thelas's house. It's here in Balmora, along the river on the east side. Ask her where the rats are coming from. Kill the rats and get your payment. Report back to me once you've taken care of it. So this isn't so much of a fighter's guild as it's an exterminator's guild. Alright, fair enough. killing some rats. Every character has the same voice. Even me. I'm not even going to pretend to do like a falsetto. Nope, not going to happen. Fester, her house is here in Balmora on the east side of town near the river. East side of town. So this is east near the river. It's this one here. It's in the middle bridge. Gotcha. Pesk patrol. Better than every character having a Slavic accent. Alright. Are you the one they sent to take care of the cave rats? Why, yes I am. These rats are such a nuisance. I'm worried that they're going to eat all of my pillows. You like pillows, don't you, Blink?
Sure, why not?
Of course I do. Anyway, I've got one trapped in my bedroom here, and the other two are in the storage area upstairs. Rats, that is, not pillows. Here's the key for that door. There are at least three of these beasts. I hope I haven't gotten into the good pillows.
Make it quick, Outlander.
Okay, fine. Well, she said it upstairs, right? Do I need to go out? Oh, wait, no. There's a door there.
Make it quick.
Oh, okay. I should. They are kicking my ass. Oh man, I can't steal? That's so lame. I mean, I guess I could. Vardenfell rats the size of dogs. Well, I mean, there's a pretty big range there for dogs, too. Like, there's Pitbull, and there's Mastiff, and there's Chihuahua. They're basically rats now that I stop and think about it.
I'm waiting.
Okay, do I need to come back to her? No, I can probably just go back to them. I'll take your word that the cave rats are dead. Here, take these 100 septums. It's what I agreed to pay the Fighters Guild. Alright. Pleasure to be of service.
What do you want?
See, you gotta start out small. Gotta start out small, and then we'll go ahead and be fighting gods in no time. Gotta kill the rats, though. Sort of a mainstay for Tess.
So what do you want?
So you killed the rats. Not bad. For you. Ready for more orders? For RPGs in general, yeah, it's a rite of passage, man. Always the first quest. Why do I get the feeling that that's Rolston's quest right there? Who knows? A local egg mine has problems with egg poachers, and you're gonna solve those problems. Yes, egg poachers. May sound silly, but those Quorma eggs are among the few things worth exporting from this nasty province. Dram, the owner of Shuck Egg Mine, wants to make an example of these thieves, to keep other miners from getting funny ideas. The egg poachers, Sevio and
Danila are former egg miners and longtime local troublemakers. You can handle that, can't you? Report back when the poachers are dead. In Baldur's Gate 1, when I got that rat quest, I accidentally killed the cats too. Oh my god! Really?
Dirt, 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 everywhere, dirt.
Dirt, 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 dirt. Okay, so there's an egg mine. Is that the one that we... Did we get instructions to that? Shuck egg mine, report back. Okay, yeah, well, where is the egg mine then? Here I am, ready to go off my grand adventure, and... There we go. The mine is a short distance southwest of Valmora in the bluffs west of the Odai River. The old suspension bridge across the Odai is just southeast of the mine entrance. Follow the river south of Balmora until you see the bridge overhead. You're not afraid of a little swim, are you? No, of course not. That's what I thought. I thought it was that egg mine, but I wasn't sure. You didn't know the controls all that well, so you were force attacking everything? Oh, that's so horrible! You just killed... Poor kittens. Yeah, that's what I thought, but I just wanted to make sure, that's all. This place looks way different without a lot of mods. Like, normally there's tons of foliage, tons of grass. Typically, I'm using Mike and Ike's Balmora mod too, so that makes it feel a lot larger. Yeah, see, there they are. That's interesting.
Sorry, stranger. My time is short, so get on with it.
If you want something, now's the time to talk.
Man, Cyril. He's got such a good voice. I mean, totally not Cyril, but it's Cyril. I should really... add torches to that, shouldn't I? Man, those things are pretty nasty looking. Yee. Wait, did I just do a big loop? No, okay. Could be in hiding anywhere in the mine. Okay. Oh, that's cool. They got a little minecart. I never used that. I've always wondered what this minecart was. Like, I've never actually seen it.
Your neck coming here.
Hmm. Never seen it in game. I've always seen it inside of the editor, though. I'm assuming that they're going to just go ahead and attack me on sight, so... Exploring this place is probably the best way to find them. With weapons drawn. Uh-oh. Yeah, there we go.
Great.
I might have to pack out of this. Okay, time to back out. I think I have a ring of healing, don't I? Is that all that I have? Do I not have anything like else than heals? Tsujamas, huh? Well, I got one Tsujama. No, no, I need to go. Goddamn. I'm thinking maybe I can snipe one of them. Oh, no, I sold those, didn't I? I got one of them. Okay, that's a little too close. I got trapped by the geometry. Oh my god. Okay. Because the freaking torch wouldn't let me move. We can do this. We can get this. Nasty little grubs. Okay, so this is where we were at before. And let's... There we go. Sanctuary, 50 points on self for 50 points for 60 seconds on self. What does Sanctuary do? Ooh, that's nice. They have no silver weapon, cannot hit your ancestral ghost, and the lover drain fatigue is super strong. Okay, good to know. We will do that next time.
You talk too much, Outlander.
I haven't said anything. Okay, I can tell already that I need to have that mod that's installed that fixes these little icons so that I don't need to go through every single one of these. Because I feel like I've just missed like another health potion. Fortify health, that's not what I want though. I want a restore health potion. Yeah, okay. There is an MCP option to let you see the effects. Well, no, I don't want the tooltip. I need to have the icon itself changed. Ooh, that's not bad. Restore health 10 points for 2 seconds on self. We could use a healing spell. You can do a custom healing spell too. I don't think that's necessary right now. Maybe when we get higher level or something we will, but... Correct me if I'm wrong, but don't the spells inside of... The ones that are named, aren't those a little bit more powerful than the custom spells that you do? No, I'm going the wrong direction, aren't I? Yeah, that's not a bad idea. I was just about to head over to Cassius again, or... Cassus?
What's your story?
We should level up here a little bit more. You got both of them? Good. Here's your payment, 100 septums. And we've got some extra potions from a recent raid. Hey, there you go. Take these, they'll come in handy. Just tell me when you're ready for more orders. Caius, that's right. Caius like Gaius with a C. We have a contract from the Caldera Mining Company to kill 4 Telvanni agents responsible for trouble at the Caldera Mine. 4 Telvanni agents are responsible for thefts and disappearances at the Caldera Ebony Mines. They're hiding in a cave in the hills north of the Caldera Mine. When the 4 agents are dead, report back to me. Take care. It's very likely that one of them is on the lookout, posted outside the mines. The quickest way to Caldera is probably to have the guild guide at the Mage's Guild transport you, but it's your choice. Now, I think we'll walk there. I think we'll...
Anytime you're ready.
Take the long route. So are those the chests that you mean, or... Oh. Let me save before I try anything. I don't need 10 of those. I can just... 2 is fine. I did take a marksman skill. That's true. Arrows probably would be a good thing. I don't have a bow. But I guess I could throw them at,
I'm listening.
At the Telvanni. Can I tell you where to get some free crossbows here in town? No. I want to discover that on my own. They probably sell bows. Yeah, there is a trader on... over here, right? Yeah, this is the Khajiit. Barter. Good enough. We'll take the short bow. Wouldn't thrown arrows be darts? You know, that's a really good point. It's actually a glitch. It's in the shop, but it's not marked as owned. Ooh, and then we'll take a lantern too. So I'm betting that the Telvanni are going to have some greaves that I can use, so I'm not going to buy them off of this guy. Oops. There we go. So, we're going to be walking to Caldera, right? Caldera is north of Balmora, I believe.
Quickly, Outlander. I haven't much time.
You do bring up a really good point, Bob. I never really thought of it that way, but that's true. Correct me if I'm wrong, guys. This is the way to Balmora. This is the way to Caldera, right? Surely there's got to be signposts here somewhere. Okay, so that's the city marker. It's funny, I never really think of Balmora as extending this far out. That's kind of a cool... a shot, though. Like, when you're in the sea, as you can see it from this distance. When you're in-game, you totally can't.
The only reason why I can see it right now is because I have a distant land set up. Interesting. I bet you that when the developers first made this, there was a larger draw distance, and then they had to cut that out at a later point. Because that looks fantastic. Oh, okay. So, Caldera is that away. You know, I just realized something. I am not streaming in the right section, am I? I'm streaming inside of... Hold on just a second here. Yeah, right now it's saying that I'm streaming inside of the game development area, and that's not what I want to be. I want to be in the... Oh, I don't know how to do this. Not game development. No. It needs to be... Yeah, I'm streaming in game development right now. I need to double check exactly what it's called. Like the Morrowind specific. Because it could be The Elder Scrolls 3 Morrowind, it could be Tess 3 Morrowind. Like, it's important to get that exact naming down. Otherwise, people aren't going to be able to find it. Cool. All right, I think we're good. Ooh, that's neat. So, I don't know who originally developed the sunrises and the sunsets for MGEXE, but whoever did made a fantastic job of it. Yeah, this is only a distant land for about 3 cells. It's not anything crazy, but it does just look so much better. Just to give like the extra little bit of distance. Okay, so we're in Caldera. Where do we need to go? Find and kill four Telvanni agents responsible for the thefts and disappearances of the Caldera mines. They're hiding in a cave in the hills north of Caldera. Okay.
Let's hear it.
That's pretty cool. I have spent maybe a total of 10 minutes in Caldera. Is it going to let me go over? Caldera Mine is west of Caldera proper. Ooh, okay, so am I at the Caldera Mine? Right, okay. Thank you so much. Yeah, I was just about to go inside of an ancestral tomb. So I'm guessing it's like maybe here? Probably on the right way. Hail and well met, stranger. As ye can plainly see, I require some assistance, if ye be kind enough to grant it. I need help finding the festering witch who has robbed me blind and left me for dead. A witch she had to be. I was on my way to Caldera when I met her. She was a stranger here, like myself, and our conversations lightened the burden of travel. She was quite friendly, and, well, you know, we set up camp together. But that night, she revealed the witch inside, cast a spell on me. I couldn't so much as blink. Stole everything, even my worn-out clothes. But most importantly, she took my prized axe Cloud Cleaver. Join with me, stranger, and let's find her and exact her entrails together. You know what? I'm good. Bah, I took you for a coward the moment I saw you. Stand aside, then. Make way for a real warrior who will be walking this path.
By the gods, you tourists are a nuisance.
I mean, he says she's a witch, but is she really? Darmok and the Caldera Mining Corporation. Naked Nord, bro. Ooh, this is cool. Where's the nudity mods? That's on my other install. I have like 6 different installs, seriously. Okay, so we're in the Caldera mine. In the cave in the hills north of the Caldera mine. Okay, so we need to go north of it. Oh, crud, I've angered it. I do not need help with that. Nasty bugger. Oh, I've got a healing spell, don't I? See, this is the Skyrim way of approaching stuff. If I had a horse, I'd just jump across it. But alas. Alright, so they say that the hill's north of Caldera, which means I'm guessing it's not inside the crater itself. This is a cool environment. A little undetailed, but cool. How do I get back up there? Strange to see the bow held in the right hand. Ooh. You get a bonus for making a sneak attack, right? Or is that just a... a Skyrim and Oblivion thing? Oh, come on. There's no way that he saw me. Yeah, I always think that this area, that someone should do something with this area in a mod. It's certainly unique. I love how everything's spaced out like it is. There's this tendency in a lot of mods to, and I'm kind of guilty of this too, as to like clutter these things together. This is a really good exercise in minimalism here. This is... I feel like it needs more detail, yes, but the distance of the large things apart from one another... that's really well done. Ooh, that's cool. Okay, so we found Caldera Mine. We found Caldera. I'm guessing that we need to go ahead and get out of the crater and explore a little bit to the north of it. Where is it? This thing here? Is this where it's at? A right-handed person would hold the bow in the left hand and draw the arrow with the right. Kind of feels like a ghost town. It does. I think that partially is because of the... it's really gray here. Having that fog makes it feel much more like a ghost town. Sort of misty quality. And not having a lot of people too, but... Alright. How are you guys liking the music, by the way? Is it good? Do you want to go ahead and go back to the Morrowind stuff? I'm down for it. This looks suspicious. Right here? You're pretty sure that cavern? Which one do you mean? Do you mean this one, or do you mean the one inside of... We can go back to that other one and check it out. I don't think I actually saw the name of the door, so it's entirely possible. They said in the... When they gave me the quest, that there would be somebody waiting outside who was a lookout as a Telvanni agent who would probably attack me. And since nobody attacked me, that's why I didn't... Yeah, the one inside the crater. I just kind of assumed. Aralyn. Okay, so if we have an Aralyn. Is that you? Avaleg.
Fetcher.
No, I haven't seen any Telvanni agents around here. Although, now that you mention it... Oh, okay. Well, he was kind of a jerk. Ooh, okay. I like that. It's always a freaking Bosmer, man. Weight is 21 and value is 90. What about this? Weight is 21, value is 80. Well, I like the one that I'm wearing better. Extravagant shoes, bargain in health, fire shield. Okay. Actually, what I should do is heal myself. Ooh, okay. Oh man, I'm gonna have to fight all three of them at once. Time to go. Oh, come on, man, I'm like a level one here. Give me some rats. I have no stamina. That's what's going on here.
Oh.
Yeah, kinda. I mean, you're not wrong. Ooh, summon skeleton. I like that. It's good. What have I got right now? This is a gauntlet, not brazers. I think I like these better. So, silly question, but is there a way that I can determine what is most heavy? Or am I just gonna have to go through every single one of these? I bet you that's a big chunk of it. Why do I have four pillows?